As mentioned before, now is the time to upgrade to Windows 11 since Windows 10 support is ending soon. Previously, we extracted the Windows 11 ISO contents, performed an offline update of the mounted install.wim, and performed an update using Task Scheduler. Here, we're going to ease and streamline the update process and interactively install from the OEM or volume license ISO file from a privileged administrative workstation without needing to log into the target system. And optionally, we will install the latest OS KB update after the upgrade is complete. Did you realize that we can accomplish an in-place Windows upgrade from Linux? On a domain server, place the Windows 11 ISO file into a shared folder. In this example, I'm placing the ISO file on a DFS share. I'm also placing the latest OS KB update in the shared updates folder. Ensure the target computer meets Windows 11 system requirements. The technician performing an upgrade must have administrator rights on the target system. Note the SHA-256 hash of the source ISO file so we can verify file integrity later. For this example, we have a domain joined Windows 10 22H2 Enterprise client that is fully updated. Installed applications include Microsoft M365, otherwise known as Office, Microsoft Power BI Desktop, VS Code, and Visual Studio 2022 with the .NET Desktop development workload. The hardware, virtual hardware in this case, is compliant and has TPM 2.0. BitLocker is on and enabled. Log into a privileged administrative workstation and open an administrative PowerShell session or terminal. We will accomplish the upgrade via remote PowerShell sessions. Set a couple of variables for source, destination, and ISO file name. Use RoboCopy to copy the Windows 11 ISO file to a local folder on the target system. Likewise, you can use File Explorer to copy the ISO to the destination computer. Optionally, check the file hash of the copy file and compare it to the known hash to verify file integrity following the copy operation. Establish a persistent PS session using the new-PSSession commandlet. Using new-PSSession allows the technician to exit while the processes continue to run. Enter the session using enter-PSSession. Now, at the console of the remote system, mount the ISO file. Get the drive letter of the mounted image by piping the get-disk image output to the get-volume commandlet and assigning it to a variable. Create a local Windows event log and a local folder for the upgrade logs. Get BitLocker status and, if necessary, temporarily disable it to avoid potential recovery prompts later. Write a Windows event log and use the start-process commandlet with the -load user profile option and pass the arguments for a silent installation. The -load user profile option is important when you're not actually logged into the remote system. If omitted, the start-process command may hang and fail later. That's it. You can exit the session and close the PowerShell terminal, or start the upgrade on another target Windows 10 client. Provided the target systems meet Windows 11 system requirements, they will be upgraded and automatically rebooted. Depending on various factors, the upgrade process can take a couple hours or more. Congratulations! You have successfully and easily upgraded to Windows 11 25H2. You can allow updates to occur through your normal update channels and procedures, or apply them immediately, which is what I'm going to do here. Copy the latest OS KB updates to the upgraded system. Reestablish the remote session. Check the OS version and build number and write to the event log. Here, I will create a function that installs the OS and .NET framework updates and reboots when complete. After the update reboot, check for the updated version number, applied hotfixes, BitLocker status, resume BitLocker if necessary, and dismount the ISO. Remove the ISO and update files from the upgraded computer. log in, or RDP into the upgraded system to make a visual confirmation. Using similar procedures, we can upgrade a remote Windows 10 client to Windows 11 from a domain-joined Linux workstation. First, ensure the target system to be upgraded has OpenSSH Server installed and configured. From the Linux client, SSH into the Windows 10 computer. I was able to log in without using a password by relying on SSH keys. By default, SSH will dump the user into the command processor, otherwise known as command prompt. Type PowerShell to enter PowerShell and verify by typing get-host. Ensure your account has admin rights. The procedures and processes to upgrade are essentially the same. However, in this case, we have to keep the SSH session open while the upgrade is in process. But you can minimize the terminal while you work in other terminals. Of course, you can perform an interactive upgrade using the normal Windows Setup GUI. RDP into the target system to be upgraded. Even when performing an interactive upgrade, there are some suggestions to help ensure a smooth and uneventful upgrade. If the drive is protected with BitLocker, manually suspend protection during the upgrade process. However, the Windows 11 upgrade will automatically suspend BitLocker during the upgrade. Check programs and features to ensure there aren't any old or incompatible applications. Copy the Windows 11 ISO file to a local folder on the target system. Double-click to mount the ISO to a drive letter. Launch Setup. Click Change How Setup Downloads Updates. Here, you can allow or disallow the setup routine to download updates during the upgrade process. Selecting Not Right Now is faster if you install KB updates post-upgrade. Accept the license terms that I know you read and studied. There will be a quiz this upcoming Thursday. Confirm Keep Personal Files and Apps is selected and click Install. Because you're an RDP session, you can safely disconnect, but do not sign out. The upgrade will continue and the computer will be rebooted as necessary. After the upgrade completes, reconnect via RDP, verify the version build, and resume BitLocker if necessary. Apply the latest Windows 11 KB updates. Finally, check Active Directory to ensure the upgrade is properly reflected. From a privileged administrative workstation, open either Active Directory Users and Computers or Active Directory Administrative Center. Search for one of the upgraded computers, right-click, and select Properties. Verify the OS name and OS version fields. In PowerShell, use the get-80 computer commandlet to query the operating system and operating system version properties. To see all Windows 11 systems, filter by operating system property. I hope you enjoyed this video, found it helpful and informative. If you have feedback, corrections, or suggestions, please share them in the comments below. Please like, subscribe, and share this video with others. Thank you for watching. I truly appreciate it.